Good afternoon, all. Today I'm going to talk about ovarian cancer management in 6.5 minutes. Tough. So starting with the problem, disease burden itself, it's the sixth most common cancer in female. Almost 40,000 new cases every year is diagnosed. Out of that, the main thing is 27,000 women dies. So it's a very highly lethal with high mortality. If we see 5-year survival, which is the lowest in worldwide, which is just 15%. And the irony is because it has very non-specific symptoms, so most of the cases, almost 80% cases, presents with advanced stage already as stage 3 and stage 4. So talking about the standard of care for ovarian cancer, we always prefer doing primary surgical staging and optimal debulking of all the macroscopic tumor, followed by systemic chemotherapy of 6-cycle platinum doublet. But everyone is not the candidate of primary surgery. Depending on the volume of disease, location of disease, if we can't achieve complete cytoreduction, then we, or patient is not fit for extensive primary surgery, then we give them neoadjuvant chemotherapy 3-cycle, followed by we do interval debulking surgery and then 3 more cycles of platinum doublet. The mode of spread of ovarian cancer is usually it spreads, mainly originates and spreads in the peritoneal cavity. So most of the times it is limited in the abdominal and peritoneal cavity at time of origin. Even the recurrences are also very common in this site. So most of the patients, almost 80% CAOV patients, they respond very well to platinum doublet therapy. Still, when we look at the survival number, the progression-free survival, when we talk about, it's just 16 months. Whatever you do, how much ever extensive, beautiful surgery you do, you give platinum therapy and platinum-sensitive disease. But these numbers have remained static throughout the decades. Overall survival, if we talk about, is maximum up to 14 months. And so, yes, the 5-year survival is just 15%. So over the years, we are not able to change this number, and that's why we need a new hope. The primary surgery, if you do complete debulking, you can give survival up to 39 months. But if you leave a residual tumor of even more than 1 centimeter, that survival drops down to 11 months. So it is the most important prognostic factor, and first surgery is very important surgery. But yes, over the decade, we are able to change some surgical techniques with advancement, surgical skills. But yes, there are no major changes in the surgery. Then we talk about systemic chemo. We thought about giving chemotherapy in a different route to improve that number of survival. So giving chemo in the peritoneal cavity was already tried in past, because we know the origin is in the peritoneal cavity. And when we give chemo there, it's a high concentration and prolonged exposure occurring right in the tumor microenvironment. And we have randomized controlled trial proven benefit of this survival. We could give almost 35 months, which was double than that 16 months. And we can give overall survival of 65 months. But intraperitoneal chemotherapy has its own disadvantage. In all the trials, they have shown only 40-42% could finish the complete 6 cycles because of catheter-related complications, sepsis. It is difficult to handle that intraperitoneal chemo-related port and higher toxicity with subsequent systemic IV chemotherapy. So that also made us scratch our head what else we can do. Almost 80% patient recurs in 1 to 2 years of proper treatment. And we know most of the recurrences happens in the peritoneal surface. So we gave a thought of giving IP therapy, but we wanted to overcome the catheter related complications, and we wanted most of the patients should be able to finish the subsequent IV chemotherapy. And there came the new hope, HIPEC, which is a hyperthermic intraperitoneal chemotherapy, which is given in a single setting. The temperature of chemotherapy is kept about 41 to 42 degrees centigrade with a hypeic machine system available. Rationale for using hyperthermic intraperitoneal and single application is hyperthermia itself causes DNA damage, denaturation of protein. So it acts as synergistic with the chemotherapy drug. Plus, we are giving it in the intraperitoneum. So we are maintaining the advantages of intraperitoneal chemo, like maximum concentration, higher peritoneum to plasma barrier and concentrations. Plus, we are giving in the single application. So subsequent IV chemotherapies are not suffered. So we can call it as microscopic cytoreduction also. So current indications are in primary ovarian cancers, recurrent ovarian cancers. We can use it in colorectal cancers, appendiceal cancers, pseudomyxoma peritoni, and any peritoneal malignancies and mesothelioma. So we have evidence phase 3 trial, which was published in 2018, which has shown the recurrence-free survival benefit of 3.5 to 4 months with application of HIPEC. And with that, almost 11.8. So you can give one more extra year to patient, improve overall survival for one more year, which is worth it. So conclusion is that HIPEC is given as a single application intraperitoneally. It improves recurrence-free survival. Median overall survival is also improved. And most importantly, we were always worried about the morbidity or complications. So this trial itself proved there was no additional complications. The morbidity was same. There was no negative impact in health-related quality of life. And there was, most importantly, there was no delay in starting IV chemotherapy, which was the major drawback in IP trials. Even we have evidence in recurrent CA ovary phase 3 trial has proved that we could give survival benefit of 26 months versus 13 months. So almost doubles the survival. So I would just briefly show this video of a minute. This is the peritoneal disease. Everything was debulked. The whole peritoneum is removed. Total peritonectomy is done. Liver capsule also, Gleason capsule also is removed. The whole pelvis is cleared. As we said, maximum cytoreduction is the most important prognostic factor. If you don't do a good surgery, chemotherapy won't help you. This is the way we give HIPEC. So it's a machine system through which the temperature is maintained around 41 to 42 centigrade. Once the surgery part is over, then we insert this system and we give chemotherapy at desired temperature. For almost 90 minutes, the chemo will stay in the peritoneal cavity. So this is the pictorial diagram of the scene. That's an open technique of doing HIPEC. I hope I could conclude. Thank you.